Hey Capricorns, patience is a simple superpower. I pulled out the karma card so we can look at the planet y'all rule by and the house that y'all sit in. Y'all children of destiny. The 10th house being a house of career automatically makes you a child of destiny. So patience isn't hard if you understand that you're a child of destiny. Once you understand that you're a child of destiny, then you can kind of fix your mind on seeing the game that's being played so that you don't become a victim of the game that people play. Don't play. If you know you're a child of destiny, what the fuck you need to play a game for? The maturity that brings. So, to me, that's kind of being, having knowledge of self to know that you're not mature enough to handle something, or not to fool yourself into thinking that you're not mature enough to handle something. So y'all patience gotta be fluid. Kind of like what they say in the book of Ecclesiastes, you gotta know when to move and when to stand still. You gotta know when to talk and when to be quiet. You got to know when to fight and when not to. So most of your life will be responding to things and not reacting. That's a part of the tool of patience. Caution regarding. Be cautious about everything. Question everything. Doubt everything. Impose limits. Limits imposed. Impose limits on yourself. If you know it's a weakness, impose the limit on yourself and challenge yourself. You must wait before you can. So it's really like a self-discipline thing. It's kind of like you would be an entrepreneur whether you wanted to be or not. A world changer. Not a game changer. You're not interested in those. Be concerned about. Y'all care about people. Continue to do that. Don't let people take you out of the natural way you're set up. You just have to sow on soil that's good and not just helping whoever, anybody. Be selective. Caution regarding who you are concerned about. Be realistic. Sometimes, because y'all run a day-to-day reality, something like Virgo, sixth house, y'all goal-oriented, y'all use the most business-like way, so y'all naturally responsible people, meaning y'all always have the ability to respond, not react. When you're constantly in that kind of matrix, if you will, yeah, you get tired. However, whatever takes you off of that because you're just tired of being responsible and tired of always responding and having the ability to respond to whatever is going on more than the average person. You care more about it than somebody else kind of shit. It could cost you. It would say in this world, it'll cost you the game. However, you don't play those, remember? Dedication to achieve, focusing on, resulting from the rules imposed by. So the only rules that you would impose upon yourself is the rules that you would create for yourself to reach your goals, which is tied to your destiny, where you're going, your career, success, responsibly. Become a person of power and status. So the restriction you got to put on yourself is crazy, crazy. So I see why y'all say, shit, I'm about to cheat. On a diet, on a woman, on a man, whatever. You know, however, it could cost way more than you just sticking to the script. Tunnel vision, however, cautious when it comes to what you're concerned about. Because you may be more concerned than the people that you're concerned about. Be realistic. So how would you use patience in all that I just said? I say make it fluid. If you got water in your chart, you may want to tap into it. Know when to move, know when not to. Know when to check a bitch, smack a bitch, and know when to just walk away from one. Pick your battles. Choose them wisely. Respond. Don't react. Because you've been in the energy of responsibility. Sometimes you're so responsible, you lose the ability to respond. And you'll become reactive, a hothead. Everybody get on your motherfucking nerve. Because you've been responsible for a long, long time. And nobody seems to care. And be realistic about it. You may be right. Sometimes things are what they seem. If people don't seem to care, maybe it's because they don't. You care a little bit much more than other people. However, heavy is the head. You know, you concerned because you have a larger platform to be concerned about. That's not really tied to the people that you deal with on your day-to-day reality. Those people get on your fucking nerves. Because they don't care as much as you do. And you keep trying to figure out why not. You're wasting time. That's using patience the wrong way. You gotta know when to hold them. Know when to fold them. Know when to walk away. Know when to run. You never count your money while you're sitting at the table. Another thing y'all tend to do is take out. Y'all don't use y'all patience correctly. And then if y'all have a mate, you expect that mate to use patience like you do. And it's abusive. And that's how I would know, being the mate of a Capricorn, I would know this as a divine femme. Even if there was another sign and they did that shit. However, Capricorns tend to do it. It would alert me to the fact that they care more about the people outside the macrocosm than they did the microcosm. However, their macrocosm had become their microcosm because those are the people that they deal with on a day-to-day basis more than the people in their microcosm. So the microcosm catch hell. Do you hear me? This like an abusive father. They think he doing it right. And out of his motherfucking marbles, mine. Because you hurting your children and you hurting your mate. Because you're using patience wrong. And you're starting charity outside of your four walls instead of inside. Charity starts at home. And then it's like, I'm caring about these people. Y'all just be patient and wait while I sit up and keep caring about these people who don't care about y'all. Be realistic. Do they know what you like? Do they bring you water? Like your children or your wife or whoever really fuck with you? Y'all tend to punish the people that really fuck with you. And then show leniency and love overflowing to motherfuckers in y'all day-to-day reality that don't give a fuck about you. So these motherfuckers own y'all jobs and all that old stupid ass shit that ain't got nothing to do with nothing. Tied to career. If your foundation ain't right, honey, that 10th house ain't gonna be right. And limits gonna get imposed on your ass. And then time starts working against you instead of for you. Y'all know y'all don't like that. That nostalgia shit. Motherfuckers from y'all past. Y'all still trying to squeeze blood out of a turnip. Ain't nothing in now. It ain't even no motherfucking bones left. Ain't no marrow, bitch. What y'all there for? They don't care like you do. You think you getting up, you using the most business. Like, wait, honey, that's keeping you stuck, honey. Business keeps moving. That's why the word busy is in it. It seems like y'all busy doing nothing. Using patience the wrong way. Punishing people that do not give a fuck. They just spending your time. You're not punishing them. You're punishing the people that really love you and yourself. If they don't give a fuck, you're not punishing them by just sitting there brooding or doing whatever it is y'all do with their patients. Honey, they don't give a fuck. That bitch don't care that you won't leave. She don't care. You're just wasting time that you cannot get back because you don't want to let shit go. That's when patience works against your ass. And that's your own superpower. Mr. Knight of Pentacles, slow and steady, wins the race, not all the time. That's what you need, fluid. Run out of brake fluid and see what happens. Somebody y'all leaving in the cold, trying to be extra 10th house, and honey, you not winning. No, it's not that. See what I'm saying? You assume that people be cool when they don't be cool with what you're doing. And them the motherfuckers that got your back. Wake up. I'm trying to tell you, sitting up there like, what is that? Even if you this motherfucker, okay, and time keeps on ticking. Saturn? I'm trying to tell you. And then y'all get all awkward at home. Y'all don't even fit in y'all house. Some of y'all got twin flames. They feel single. Because they is. Y'all just sit somewhere just like this. Blind, deaf, and dumb. Causing towers to people that y'all realize for real, deep in y'all subconscious mind. From y'all childhood. Full of fucking illusions. Don't want to let the past go. And in your mind, you know that those people don't give a fuck like you do. So you think you're going to stick around and just keep causing them towers and you're doing something with that. You're not doing anything but wasting time. And you're not going to get that time back. Even if God restores, you still can't get that time back. They're not worth that shit. Just let it alone. Before you be going looking awkward. At home. Okay? Who the fuck stays somewhere when they can get loose? You ain't hurt nobody but yourself and the people that really love you. He can get out of that. You choose to stay in that stupid ass shit. And then you don't want to swallow the fact that people been telling you to get the fuck out of certain situations. And you think you teaching these people a lesson and this and that. Man, you're not teaching them shit. What are you learning? Why you always want to be the teacher? I'm trying to tell you, some dumbass Sagittarius, y'all keep staying in conflict with. It's a fiery nature female that some of y'all divine masculines keep staying in conflict with, and they continue to hurt y'all divine feminine. Y'all don't care. Mm-mm, she can take it. She can take it. More pain, more pain. Yeah. Show me how much you love me through hurting. Like, everybody don't love that way. And if that's your love language, you need to challenge yourself on that shit. For real. Love isn't methodical like the pinnacle. The cup is not like the pinnacle. You need to add some water. Slow and steady wins the race where money is concerned, career is concerned, business is concerned, becoming a person of power and status is concerned. It does not work like that with love. You can't control it. It's not controlled. More like the tower. Confusion, brutality, chaos, inner clarity, rethinking an idea, clouded judgment. Yeah, because y'all sitting around some toxic ass shit. And you could get out of it. Y'all choosing to stay in these situations. Lying to yourselves that you're winning. by causing people confusion. It's like an old ass magic trick that is no longer relevant. You need to reform it or reprint it or something, remaster it. Because baby, when I tell you, it's not working. They do not care if you cause them confusion. They do not care if you brutalize them with your presence. They do not care that you can cause chaos. They do not care that you could give them clouded judgment. They don't care. They that without you there. You just intensify it with that fire you hold in your hand. That torch under people's ass. You steadily sitting still though. So who winning? Nobody. Because they're not alchemizing. That's who they are. You're just intensifying that. When you leave, they still going to be confused. They still going to be in chaos. They still going to be clouded in judgment. And if you think you're the balance, because you want to play some type of earth angel, honey, you wasting time. You wasting time. And somebody is still, because you're tied to a situation that you just won't break free from, that particular black widow or warlock or djinn is hurting your divine feminine. And you say she could take it. Mm-hmm. Like somebody want to be stern and like this all the time. Yet the sword came down for y'all. You see what I'm saying? Do unto others. And you're not. And you're perceiving it in a real weird way. And if y'all got cancer in y'all chart, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Y'all using patience. All kind of wrong. All kind of wrong. It's like an old, slow-ass way to uproot something. And you will be dead if you keep doing it this way without fulfilling your destiny. Just gifts stuck inside of you. Uncle Martin Luther King, who was a Capricorn, he showed people how to do it. He came in, he hit it and quit it. I think I'm going to hit it and quit it. You see the impact he made? If you say Martin Luther King, everybody know who you talk about. He died at what age? In his 30s, 33. There you go. Came in, saw. Okay, get to it. All right. See y'all later. Bye. Kind of situation. Got his twin and gone. Mm-hmm. Yes. King of Pentacles. Thank you, Aunt. Get like me. Y'all think y'all got time, and y'all do not. Mm-hmm. Then it'll flip on your ass. And then y'all be stuck in calculations and shit. And getting further caught up in a game that y'all said y'all don't play. I'm trying to tell you. Uh-huh. Some of y'all divine fems know that about y'all. Some Capricorn divine fems. Some of y'all divine masculines know that about y'all. Put distance there because they already know. They'll be fucked up fucking with you. And you would feed off of that. Because for some reason, y'all feel like suffering is attached to love. I do not know why. It is not. You can love somebody all you want to. But if you're giving me a motherfucking pounding headache, shaking my brain, doing all this weird ass shit that you do to your little day-to-day reality friends that don't give a fuck about you. That's why it's an END on the end of that motherfucker. Get the fuck on, man. And the further motherfuckers get away from you, the better they feel. The ones that truly do love you, pay attention. Some of y'all got cancer in y'all motherfucking chart. And that's how them hoes be working, y'all. I'm trying to tell you. Keep you crazy as a motherfucker. Y'all need to let all these motherfuckers go. All the motherfuckers attached to y'all motherfucking childhood. Cousins, aunts, uncle. I wouldn't give a fuck. Like my mama said, don't give a fuck. And carry the fuck on because y'all got the ability to do it. Y'all been sitting in this shit. And so has y'all twin flame. But y'all think the suffering of y'all twin flame shows that they love you. And then it's a right choice to make. Move in slowly. But steadily getting it in with these weird ass energies. Creating more work for her too. This is why they distance themselves from y'all. And y'all will start reading it as they don't love you. And y'all could have been with a motherfucker 20 years. This shit so toxic. What you mean keep watching me while you're punishing all the motherfuckers that you spending your time with? Time shows how you love somebody. People that you choose to spend your time with. You choosing to be with these motherfuckers all around. That's showing love to them. Not who you leaving at home. Not who you leaving in the motherfucking Five of Pentacles. So guess what they gonna do? Put that bitch in reverse because you skunking up the place, nigga. That's not my love language. And you hurt. The fuck? And then the reader, that they don't love you. What? They don't love punishment and pain. You do, clearly. That's how they get y'all. I'm trying to tell you and to subdue you in a minute. Some weird ass bitch with no juice to subdue a Capricorn man. They will. They will keep flipping it till y'all get tired. I'm trying to tell you. Especially when they fiery. Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. I'm trying to tell you. Hard-headed in a motherfucker. People in your past, get over it. For real. Keep on giving to the same motherfucking devils. You're not winning. They are. Putting yourself on some weird ass restriction. I'm going to wait it out. Type of niggas that always want to keep leftovers. Throw that shit away, honey. I'm trying to tell you. Y'all be cut off. Y'all divine mates be cutting y'all off. Because y'all hurt. Y'all sit. Like a motherfucker is cement. No. No, that is so wrong. That is so wrong. Oh, they be crossing y'all up with that shit. I'm trying to tell you, they really do. Y'all need some water. They do. They'll keep making down look up and up look down. Mm-hmm. And y'all just be sitting there rapping them with that shit like y'all teaching them something. Y'all not teaching them nothing. They just wasting your fucking time and trying to shatter your fucking dreams. You ain't doing nothing but getting older and older, trying to put something in a deadlock situation like they owe you something. They don't got nothing for you. These motherfuckers is dead, done. Fuck, you gonna go in their pockets, nigga? Do that and get the fuck on the good foot before you just sit up and patronize these motherfuckers. Honey, baby, y'all using patience wrong than a motherfucker. Limited fluidity. Capricorns that got that fluidity, that Martin Luther King fluidity in and up out of there. Honey, baby, y'all know what it is. Because the archaic way that some Capricorns operate, honey, I don't know where the fuck you think you're getting with that. Some of the 80s babies Capricorns operate so silly. 90s too. You'd be like, what? You're not hurting nobody. You're not about to come home. You're not about to come home to nothing. You're about to come home to nothing. Kind of shit. For real. Ain't nobody obligated to sit in pain like that to prove that they love you. Just because you looking at motherfuckers that you thought dead, but realize they didn't. So you going to sit there and try to think that's going to hurt them and you going to get some payback by hurting them. No, they Ten of Swords already. Walk out. Fold them, nigga. For real. So many secrets. Y'all don't tap far enough into y'all intuition. Y'all need to go deeper into y'all intuition. If y'all got Pisces or Cancer or Scorpio in y'all chart, y'all need to tap into that motherfucker. Because y'all do not tap in. Y'all will see something is fucked up and then go to punishing. However, you got to go deeper into what's fucked up about that motherfucker. And then that's going to make you move your fucking feet. Because you're going to realize that motherfucker ain't worth a food stamp. Ain't worth my time. Ain't worth my energy. Ain't worth a word. Ain't worth a good morning. Ain't worth nothing. For real. For real. That's that fiery temperament that some of y'all got if y'all are born in the late December. And then that's something that y'all have just as Capricorns. Y'all have a snap fire kind of anger because y'all a cardinal sign. That's a pop off. But you burn out like the phoenix. Crash and burn. Y'all have the potential to outlast anybody where pain body is concerned. However, they can fucking subdue you where you can't move Stonehenge and it won't be that tight on you. So that spit fire, that get moving, you gonna need that to break through whatever these chains is of illusions that they got y'all in, thinking that y'all winning by sticking around to show them they didn't beat you or whatever. Y'all not into, y'all not using y'all intuitive muscle enough. Because if y'all really were, y'all would not be celebrating with these motherfuckers. Y'all wouldn't be drinking with these motherfuckers. Y'all wouldn't be smoking with these motherfuckers. Y'all would not be talking to these motherfuckers. Y'all would get on that arrogant shit y'all know how to get on. For real. Somebody tricked y'all to be extra humble. And that shit ain't working, bro. Oh, no. No. Somebody may be giving y'all migraines. Possibly a fire sign, Gemini, giving y'all migraines. Either to alert y'all to wake the fuck up. Y'all may be getting hit by a Gemini aunt and a karmic Leo. And y'all are sitting in that shit instead of getting up, Knight of Swords, and getting the fuck out of there. Okay? I wouldn't give a fuck what baby you got with the bitch. I'm telling you, this is crazy. Yeah, they watch y'all be fools kind of shit. Somebody y'all fucking or was. Y'all at work, routine, Knight of Pentacles ass shit. Come home, go to sleep. Know y'all routine. Got y'all like a motherfucking yo-yo. And they work with people. Sorority groups, I heard. Bitches in sorority covens. Church covens. Church and sorority covens. Yeah, they got y'all all the way fucked up. If y'all got pain, like migraines where it's in your eyeballs, y'all need to wake up. Y'all fucking around, man. They trying to trap y'all. Y'all just sitting there. Y'all can break out of that shit. Y'all think y'all can't. They tricked y'all like that bullshit lion strapped to a plastic chair. I'm trying to tell y'all. Some of y'all got divine femmes, Virgo energies, Taurus, Capricorn like y'all, honey. When I tell you. I'm telling y'all, Ben told y'all to get on the move, get going. What the fuck is wrong with you? It was witchcraft. I'm trying to tell y'all. If y'all can't figure it out, why y'all way don't work no more? Why y'all feel stuck? Why it ain't working? Why I feel like it's working against me and not for me? That's the reason. Somebody thought they had y'all a number working witchcraft on y'all like a motherfucker. Somebody y'all underestimated. So says my mother. A Leo energy. Straight up devil. Mm-hmm. Y'all, dad done went out. You done got fat sitting there looking goofy. Oh, yeah. Straight up need to go to the penitentiary. A bitch from a Lifetime movie that look like that fake smiles card in their Oracle deck. Celebrate with their friends. Doing work on you. Got y'all in y'all routine. Knight of Pentacles. And work the fuck out of it. Be gossiping about you. All kind of shit. This is exactly what the fuck y'all gonna do. If y'all don't leave it a bloody scene. And the police should really mind their motherfucking business. Some of y'all dealing with a Leo. Tricky ass bitch. When y'all really see how she look, now that y'all out of this bullshit, y'all enlightened from me ringing that bell. Next time y'all see that hoe, whoever this hoe is, fire sign energy, y'all gonna see who she ain't. Y'all gonna see who he ain't. I'm talking about motherfuckers gonna be looking like a goat. like a bulldog, like a bull mastiff, like a goddamn Doberman Pinscher, like a goddamn, I ain't lying. Compared to who y'all twin is? Oh, shit, dog fool. A tricky bitch working magic? Oh, yeah. Y'all get y'all in y'all sleep. Y'all think she harmless. Y'all think he harmless. Yeah. Because they appear to be. However, they are not. They a killer. They a black widow. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, y'all think they harmless and shit. Be running them around. Doing shit for honey, please. Giving y'all all kind of cardiac arrest. Doing all kind of shit. Every little dime they get, honey, they will be there at the witch doctor. Trapping y'all in that motherfucking routine. Before y'all know it, y'all feeling like a Taurus. Stuck. And y'all ain't a fixed sign. Y'all a cardinal sign. Y'all have the ability to act as a fire sign. Pop off. Yeah. And it hurt. Oh, yeah. Like, remember, you used to wet a rag and pop a nigga on the back of the neck? That's how y'all can say something, a sentence, and burn a motherfucker's soul. For real. And just be like, and they be fucked up. I'm talking. You feel me? Way more than you just sitting. That's how I know y'all ain't went into y'all intuition. And y'all thought somebody was harmless. Because they appeared to be. Oh, no. Mm-mm. Got plenty of friends they work their bullshit with. Oh, yeah, my mother keeps saying it. Mm-hmm. Thought they got the winner. Some of y'all was popular in school. Thought they got the winner. I got him. Like it was a game. Some Leo bitches. Aries, Sag. I ain't lying. Was gonna keep y'all today old and gray. Till that shit start looking stupid. To some of y'all, what the fuck am I in? It just ain't backwards and goofy. Kind of shit. Okay. That would be y'all tapping into y'all intuition. They keep y'all in conflict, ripping and running for them. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Oh, they played a dirty game. Oh, yeah. I'm getting chills. Keep coming up. This motherfucking bitch. My mother is trying to tell my brother, I guess. This motherfucking bitch, man. Get rid of that bitch, man. She evil. Right. It ain't heartbreaking to me. Is it heartbreaking to you? Because I don't give a fuck. I really don't. She thought she was better anyway. And where'd she even come from? Where's Kendra? Kind of shit. Like, where's my mama? The fuck? Right. Knew what she was doing. Tricky ass bitch. Knew what she was doing. Playing the game, man. Playing the game, bro. Yes. From way back. Yeah. Some of y'all was popular niggas. And a dumb, corny ass bitch played the game and won. Because she that motherfucking sinister. Mm-hmm. Using that Leo wrong ain't got no business. More than likely, that fire in that sign, the strength of that sign, they have it mentally and it break down their body physically. If they don't use it right. Mm-hmm. Scorch their ass. So you see why you ain't got that? Uh-huh. Because they composed fucked up. Mm-hmm. From the start. Should have been aborted. Yeah. Emotionally immature, insecure. And y'all will stay with a motherfucker like that. And they'll give y'all creative blocks. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, a disappointment. Absolutely. When you look at the bitch, you're definitely going to be disappointed. And it does not fit any of your expectations in that 10th house. So says my mom. And my brother's mom. Mm-hmm. Devil. You ain't the devil. They had behind you. More than likely, their parents thought they was calling themselves checking you, and they should check their fucking demonic ass seed. I'm trying to tell you, somebody's father thought they was checking you. No, he need to check that bitch that came out of his dick. This ain't Texas. Ain't no hold 'em. So lay it down. Pop your Lexus and eat your Texas toast with your spaghetti with the blood in it. Fucked around and found out. Ooh, we about to take that staff and become a Leo and whoop our ass, is you? Yeah, self-discipline, boredom, feeling stuck, perfectionism, work without reward. Don't even like y'all. Did the spell work on it with a sorority, coven, church, witch, bitches, black widow, gin-ass motherfuckers, and then get bored, don't know, because it ain't yours. That love ain't yours, bitch. That's why you're bored and you're getting busy, bitch, and too busy, because you're touching people that got a mama like you. You ain't the only one that they think is the apple of their eye and all that shit, bitch. Somebody mama feel that way about her son. Somebody daddy feel that way about his daughter, bitch. You ain't the only daughter and son on the motherfucking planet, stupid ass bitch. The fuck? Time to heal and get the fuck out of there. For real. Ugh, right. How even let a bitch touch your dick? Get this bitch some money and get the fuck on. Then end up having a child that's just like the man they trapped that come to save them from this weird ass scenario. And who is that calling me? Kind of shit. Children born, I'm trying to tell you to call judgment on the bitch that called them down there trying to trap their daddy for money on some old bullshit. Motherfuckers gonna be going to prison. That's what the fuck you gonna be doing. Why you think you just so much better? I'm trying to tell you. Yeah, end up being just like the father, then they don't know what to do with it. Because you shouldn't have been touching it in the first place, bitch. Some people been carrying these burdens for so long, man. Go in on these motherfuckers, man. I do not give a fuck. Don't pity party. Don't do none of that shit. Just get to walking. Why that bitch don't say shit? Because she caught or he caught with the dumb shit they be on. Wait till y'all see the motherfucker that had y'all strapped to a plastic chair. Terrible. Terrible. And some of y'all children ain't with it. But never with it. No. Y'all think y'all doing the right thing. Y'all mama raised y'all right. Yada, yada, yada. You ain't about to be like these other niggas. I understand. However, you got to use your intuitive muscle because it ain't one of your superpowers. That don't mean you can't cultivate it and get it tighter than a motherfucking Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio, okay? Call a spade and quit trying to make shit other than what the fuck it is. All right, Capricorn, loving life.